Sorry, guys. I wanted to put some music on it, and I was going to pause the live video. So I have a little music in the background. That's what I'm listening to. This is on my playlist on Spotify. It's my inspiration playlist. I think this one's public. I need to make sure. By the way, you guys, check out the view. I really lucked out with this room. The Crown Tower is hooked it the fuck up. Ooh, look at that. There's Perth, Australia. Look at the view. So I'm taking your questions. You guys want to know? Nirvana. Ooh, that would be a good one to add into the set. Yeah, maybe someday. That's a pretty one. Kind of obscure, but I wrote it. You would 100% do? The sound of the new album? It's still kind of being worked out, but it's definitely a bit more organic than the last album. More real instruments, I think, that are more present than maybe overall on the last album. A lot of guitars, bass, great bass lines. A lot of it seems so far to be a bit more retro, which is kind of cool. Throwback, classic. But in a modern way. Naturally. Hi, I'm Fran. Got family on here. Who knew you were up on the Instagram? Yes, we were all shocked when Dayla sent herself home on RuPaul's Drag Race. Now having watched the season, I'm even more shocked because she was doing such a good job. She was having a bad day when she was recording her song. I didn't really know that, so I was kind of like, ooh, is she all right? And then she got up there, and she was badass. I mean, she killed the performance. It was so good. Just goes to show you with drag, it's such an interesting art because some people are better at certain things than others. You know, being behind a microphone isn't necessarily what a lot of drag queens are experienced with. They're experienced with getting on stage and lip syncing. That's like the thing that most queens do to like make a coin. So seeing the behind the scenes, the process of creating the song, and then the difference between that and getting on stage was really interesting. Because you see the real experienced performers really shine in that moment. Lower the music. Oh, you can't hear me? Is it too loud? Shit. Sorry. Yes, that would make sense because it's coming from the phone. Can you guys hear me now? Is that better? You miss my blue hair? Oh, that was a long time ago. Goals this year? Well, I got more touring to do with Queen. We announced some tour dates this summer in Europe, cities we didn't go to last year, cities that I really like. I think there'll be more announced soon. And I'm going to finish this album up hopefully before then, so it'll be ready to go after the tour at some point. Other goals? Just to stay happy and healthy, you know? Yes to her, B.B. Huxley. Yes to her. Makeup tips? Blend? I don't know. No U.S. cities with Queen at this point. We did a pretty hefty tour this last summer, so I think we did the damn thing. Don't know the name of the new album yet. I'm not that far along. Isaiah, happy and healthy equals tequila. I mean, that does provide some joy. You got to keep it balanced and in check or else you become unhealthy. But yes, you know, I like a drink. Thanks, Isaiah. I saw Isaiah the other night at my show in Melbourne, and I'm so proud of Isaiah. That song has done such great numbers. I mean, everyone's heard it, and the Eurovision thing that you did. I'm so proud of you, dude. Hi, Finland. Oh, you came to the Hollywood Bowl. That was a really special two nights. Really loved that. Loved being in my hometown performing. Can you have my hair? Yes, take it. It's really messy because I just woke up. Hey, Queen. Hey, Dylan. What's up? I love this mix of fans and friends. What a nice morning. What a great wake up. Because my fans are my friends. And I hope my friends are my fans. You guys, questions would be amazing. I can give you some juicy bits. What time is it here? It's like 12-ish, noonish. I slept in. Good to do on a show day. I have a show tonight. I like to rest a lot so that I have extra juice in the battery. Happy birthday, Alexa. Fave Drag Race winner? Well, Raja is my dear friend, and it was so chic the whole time, so she's one of my favorites. I also think that Alaska Thunderfuck is hilarious. Very funny. I'm in Perth, Claire Bear, Australia. I'm coming home next week. I'll be home next week to start working, or to finish work on my album, and to keep writing music for it. Oh, I think I got enough Wicked. I think I got enough of that. TV shows that I watch? Oh man, I watch everything. I like a lot of the heavier stuff on Showtime and HBO and Netflix. I just watched an episode of Homeland last night that I really liked. Yes, I'm coming back to LA next week. Yes. Smooches! My favorite tattoo? You know, I got a tattoo of my dog, Pharaoh, on my leg that I don't think a lot of people have seen, and I'm going to show it to you. That was kind of awkward, but yeah, there you go. Yeah, of course I keep in touch with Brian and Roger when I'm out on tour. We're like family. Working on that new album, guys. That question, the question of when is, I can't tell you. I don't know exactly. I'm still working on it. No features yet, but I might be working on a couple different options for that. Got to get some music together first. I think with any album, you get a bunch of work done on it, and then you get into the final phase of it and things start accelerating and the momentum builds and things like features come up and you work with more prolific producers, and yeah, we'll see what happens in the next couple months. I'm excited. Speak peek of lyrics? What does that mean? Speak peek. Speak peek?
Yes, speak peek.